Yarana, everybody. Hello, Sherry.
Hi, Carl. Hi, everyone.
So thank you for joining everybody once again for another of our Tahitian Moment live shows that we do every Thursday. I see the numbers starting to come in and join. It's actually a big show for us. We have two people on screen right now, and then we get another two backstage waiting to join us. So
great.
So it should be a good show. So for all of you that are regulars, as you know, drop the comments, say your hellos, and please ask questions. We can see them all coming in now. I'll get to those in a minute. But for anybody who's new to watching this, if you're watching it live or you're watching the recording, just so you know, my name's Carl. This is Sherry. And I got that right.
You got that right.
so what we do is we work at Tahiti by Carl. We're also joined with our other colleague, Sarah, who's not with us today. But at Tahiti by Carl, we work with travelers to take the complexity out of planning and booking customized, memorable Tahitian vacations. So you call us, we work with you, we make a one-stop shop, and you're good to go. Today we are going to be talking about a specific sailing that I would love if you would join, because I am going to be on that sailing. And this is with, as you know, our favorite cruise line, Paul Gauguin Cruises. So we have Vicky that's going to be joining us today, but we also have Luke who's going to be joining us. And I'm not gonna get into what Luke does because he does a lot, but he's gonna be joining us as a guest lecturer on board the cruise. So if anybody's interested in joining, we hope you can join Luke, join myself. And we will be doing a beautiful Paul Gauguin cruise in May of 2025. Let's hit up the comments here because we got lots of comments pouring in. Hello, Larry. Thanks for joining, Larry. And then he also commented, hello, Sherry, when he realized Sherry. Larry and Hillary have been down to Tahiti once and we're planning their second trip. And then we have ever faithful Liz. Liz, thank you for joining us. And Liz is also saying hi, Sherry. Liz is booked to go on the Paul Gauguin again, and we were just able to confirm the water sports platform dining.
Oh, that's amazing. That'll be so cool.
She's the first person ever that I've been able to get that confirmed.
That's amazing.
And I think we asked about six times, and then finally it was available. That was super amazing. Super cool. I want pictures, Liz. I want pictures. Bradley, thanks for joining, Bradley. Bradley's all booked to go down. And Judy, thanks for joining. Judy's going down to get married, and she just surprised me. We've gone from doing a ceremonial wedding in Bora Bora to she's in the process of sending her paperwork down to the mayor of Bora Bora to actually make it a legal wedding in Bora Bora and then go back to the resort to do the ceremonial one. So congratulations.
That is super exciting.
Yeah. And Larry, that is good. Look forward to hearing what you and Hillary have decided. They've been tossing up a lot of ideas, so we'll see. And there we are, Sherry's plans rose, and I'm sure Lee is there too.
Yeah, hi.
And Liz just commenting, can't wait to experience the platform dinner on Paul Gauguin. Yes. Yeah. We actually managed to get it for two guests this past week, which is really, really
wow.
Special. Yeah.
You must have a horseshoe.
I think so, right? We should be going out and buying lottery tickets. So. Okay, thank you all for dropping your little comments in there. And please, as the show goes on, if you have any questions or comments, you know, shoot them our way. But I want to bring back to the show here. All of you know that you watch regularly. You know Vicky. She's my most repeat guest, I think, because she's always
Your Honor.
I want to talk about Paul Gauguin Cruises. How are you, Vicky?
I'm well, thank you. You too? You're looking great.
Yes, can't complain.
Good. I'm excited for Liz. I know I've been on these quite a few times when even I'm recognizing your clients' names. You know, whether they book with Paul Gauguin or not, I'm recognizing the folks. So
That's funny and true, right? You are definitely a regular. And then let me introduce everybody to Luke Yankee. So Luke Yankee is going to be the guest lecturer. Paul Gauguin always have guest lecturers on board. And this is one that Vicky and I worked with Luke to set it up for Luke to come on board. So let me just quickly bring Luke on. Hello, Luke.
Hi there. Happy to be here.
Thank you so much for joining. Luke is a writer, a director, a producer. He's a son of a famous actress. I could go on forever. I think, Luke, you've got so many.
I wear a lot of hats.
You do. You are a super busy man, but yeah, we're going to bring Luke back on afterwards. First of all, what we'll do today is Vicky and I are going to go through a presentation. We're going to try to keep it quick because we've done lots of presentations on Paul Gauguin before. So there's lots of that on our YouTube channel. Go back to the YouTubes. You can go through the videos. There's a playlist specifically called Paul Gauguin Cruises with a ton of information and videos on Paul Gauguin with full walkthroughs of the ship and everything. But Vicky and I are going to go through a little bit about Paul Gauguin, why you would want to sail with Paul Gauguin. And then we're going to go through the itinerary on the day by day of all the different ports that we'll visit on this itinerary. And we're also going to look at some of the savings that you have when you book through Sherry or myself, when you give us a call to book, the savings that you can get on the cabins. And then we will pull Luke on and get into more details as to what his background is and what he's going to do on board the ship. And super excited that you're joining us.
Great. Thank
you. Okay. So let me just pull up the presentation. One moment here. So we'll come back to you, Luke, and Sherry at the end. You can enjoy backstage. And I don't know why. I just had somebody else named Raylene that just tried to join our presentation. And I don't know who she is, so I'm just kicking her out. One second.
She wants to come on screen.
Who's Raylene? Yeah. I don't know who that is.
A little pushy.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm happy to have guests on the show. If you guys want to join the show, you people just let me know. But Raylene, you don't have a picture. And I don't know who you are. So, unfortunately, you're not today. Not today. So this is our cruise. We are doing a hosted 10-night cruise, May 14th, 2025.
Well, I think, Carl, too, I think you're underestimating how much fun it would be or what a draw it is that you're actually hosting this sailing as well. So yeah. I think that's a big draw for a lot of people. Everyone can just tell from these live streams how much fun you'd be on vacation. So
yeah, I'm sorry. Raylene is persistent. She just joined again, so I'm just banning her from the studio now. Okay, Raylene is gone. So, actually, Vicky, to tell you the truth, I'm looking forward to this because, you know, as you know, I've done two hosted cruises before, but both times it has been the first time it was all family and friends, which was great, great fun. The next time it was a huge group and it was half family, friends, and half clients. Right. And this time, I mean, I don't have any family friends planning on going. And I kind of like that because now I'm, you know, I'm free to just enjoy time with clients. So,
Yeah,
I'm looking forward to it and being able to, you know, we get to know our clients, as you say, they come on the show and we get to know people, relatively well through the booking process. So it'll be nice.
I sailed in November with your clients, a few of your clients. And that's, that was so much fun.
Yeah. Yeah, it's nice. So, this is our itinerary. So you've got myself and then,
And this is a unique new itinerary that we've really haven't done before. So we were talking before we got on air too. And I was saying, I think this is a fascinating itinerary. So it'd be fun to go through it day by day.
Yeah, for sure. It's got some beautiful beach stops, which I'm always all about. And Luke, of course, will be joining as well. And we'll get more into the details of what Luke's going to do. So I'm going to turn it over to you, Vicky.
Where is French Polynesia? You know, this is, it's surprising how few people realize where French Polynesia is in the world. It is halfway between Australia and North America. It is north of the equator. No, it is not. It is south of the equator, the same distance as Hawaii is north of the equator. But Tahiti in a year gets the same amount of tourists as Hawaii does in 7 days. So that's really what it's all about, is just this beautiful, unspoiled paradise. Loving, too, that we have the direct nonstop flights. So Los Angeles, San Francisco, and then Seattle as well, which is a really good connection.
Or Hawaii, if anybody was coming through Hawaii. So, but only once a week from Hawaii. So,
And you see, as we go, I use interchangeably French Polynesia and the islands of Tahiti, but the official name really is French Polynesia, a group of 118 islands. and take up an area in the ocean the size of Europe, but the landmass is only the size of Prince Edward Island. So unique destination to travel to. Paul Gauguin Cruises has been in French Polynesia for more than 25 years. The ship was purposely built for the islands. The secret to our success is actually the size of the vessel. It's large enough to offer a luxury experience. It's almost 20,000 tons. So it's actually quite a large vessel. It's just that we never put more than 330 guests on board. So lots of space.
Yeah. And I think that's the big thing with it is there's so much deck space, right? You're not jammed and crowded. There's always a quiet lounge. There's always deck space. There's always places that you can go. So it's, really nice.
And lots of balconies too. 70% of the vessel is built with balconies. The rest are all outside staterooms. Mm-hmm. And purposely built with that shallow draft. So that's what gives us the ability to get in close like this over the lagoons and get in so close into the islands. So that just means less time when you're tendering into the destination as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks to our all-inclusive nature, guests just arrive and it's just so easygoing because everything's taken care of. So everything from your non-alcoholic beverages, your alcoholic beverages, and the alcoholic beverages are all top shelf liquors. Very nice selections of wines. We have proper French champagne because we are a French cruise line. We are owned by Panon. They are the industry leaders with 13 vessels. Worldwide, all of their ships are on the cutting edge of technology in terms of environmental preservation as well. And when they just did a recent dry dock on board the ship, one of the things they added was Wi-Fi, and it's Starlink. So it's really nice complimentary Wi-Fi, and even our gratuities are included. So it's just an easy way to travel. You don't have to pack or unpack. You just arrive on board the ship and everything's taken care of.
Yeah, it's really just spa and shore excursions are.
Yeah. You know? We always include the tenders that take you into the islands. But yeah, you're right. Anything, if you think about it, shore excursions, spa treatments too. Every cruise line charges you for spa.
Yeah, of course, right? But that's a super inclusive, you know, cruise. Yeah. So yeah, that's great. Great.
I think what makes us different than any other luxury cruise line really that travels into French Polynesia, I mean, they were there year round and we've been doing it for 25 years, but also the laid-back luxury lifestyle on board. So it's the best food and it's the best service, which is very informal in terms of the dress code. So no jackets or ties or gowns or tiaras.
I love it.
Most North Americans do, right? Like you do want the best food and service, but you just don't want to have to be all dressed up.
Hello, especially in Tahiti. It's a very, very casual destination. It's a beach destination. The locals live looking like this guy in the picture.
Yeah, exactly.
We don't want to get suit and tie on.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, and this gentleman, he's one of our Gauguin. So we have a troop of Polynesians on board there. We call the girls are Gauguins, the boys are Gauguin. They are your hostesses. They greet you when you arrive. They are multi-talented entertainers who sing and dance. But more than that, the Tahitian people are so lovely and amiable, and they are so proud of their history and their culture, and they love to express themselves through dance and song, and they love to just really spend time with guests and let them make them aware of what their upbringing and their lives and their culture is like. So as much as we want you to come to the islands, we want you to be on board the ship and really experiencing an authentic experience, both off in the destination and when you're on board.
Yeah, and nobody does that better to bring the Polynesian culture on board the ship than what you guys do, which is why we focus, you know, on your product with our clients, because it gives you the most authentic Polynesian experience. And that's what we want to provide for our, you know, for our clients.
Yeah. Crew, we can't say enough about the crew. Carl, you have so many clients that travel with us every year. You know better than that people come back and it's astounding the compliments that we get about the crew. Well, I guess I shouldn't say it's astounding because I've sailed with them and it's amazing. We've had 5 of the crew have been on board for the full 25 years.
That's amazing.
Most have been on board for more than 10 years. And they'll remember your name. They remember, you know, unique thing, how you had your steak cooked or various things, and love to anticipate guests' needs. Yeah. So they're mostly the Gauguins, and then the crew on board are what make this such an authentic, special experience.
Yeah. And you can tell the crew the crew love each other too. They jive, they work well together. You can hear them laughing in the kitchen, and you know, which is really, you know, which is really nice as well.
Yeah, and that's, you know, part happy crew make for happy guests.
Yeah.
Longer port stays, that's what, we, as I said, we're about a destination. So when you think we're about traveling to French Polynesia, and the ship just happens to be a great way to do that. And part of that is the longer port stays. So we arrive early in the day. Often we'll leave right at supper time, but many overnights. And this itinerary that you have has a new overnight for us in Fakarava, which is really cool.
Yeah.
Various restaurants, all the dining experiences are included in the cost, so you don't pay additional for alternative dining. La Veranda is open for breakfast and lunch, and then in the evenings, we dim the lights and change the crystal and the china, and it becomes a really interesting French-inspired restaurant with a degustation or a tasting menu. And then we have Le Grill is Polynesian fusion dining. And a good tip for when your group is traveling, or any of the one that's traveling, is when you're in Bora Bora, when we overnight in Bora Bora, or any overnight, we take Le Grill out by the pool under the stars, which is really nice as well, too.
Yeah.
It's always outdoors.
Liz is going to be busy. Liz is going to be busy on the water sports platform. She won't be able to do the grill.
Oh my God. The water sport. I just want to say a couple things about the water sports platform. It really is like winning a lottery, because on any given sailing, it's only that one night that we overnight, and it's only for two or four people that know each other, but it is. And so it's very hard to get. You have to book it early and just keep checking on it. So we don't talk about it a lot because it's just such a unique experience, but anyone who's ever done it will absolutely raves about it. So you have dinner and the Gauguins sing and dance, and yeah, it's very special. And then L'Etoile is our main dining room, so all kinds of choices and variety for dining. It's international cuisine. You can have anything in your stateroom or your suite that's being served in L'Etoile in your stateroom, served course by course. There's no additional charge for that. We have early risers breakfast. We have high tea, lavish barbecue on our motu. So lots and lots of choices and variety for dining. And all included, which is great. Mm-hmm. Often you'll see our performances. Every evening there is a different type of performance. It's often the beautiful Gauguins, like this singing and dancing. We have a crew show. The crew show is actually lots of fun as well, but a different type of performance every evening. But it's authentic Polynesian style entertainment.
Yeah.
You know, someone was just telling me the other day they were doing like a land vacation. And they were saying, you know, if you're in a resort, a lot of the resorts, I guess, once a week, maybe they have the Polynesian reviews. But here, this is every evening, you know, so it's just ingrained in the experience.
Yeah, you definitely get way more. I always know when I've got clients, they're doing the Paul Gauguin, and then if they're going to a resort afterwards, we don't have to worry about, is that resort going to do a Polynesian show? Because I know on board, they will see lots of the Polynesian dancing.
Everything from, you know, on sailaways, we have by the pool, and there, tons. When you're, even the last time I was going into the motu, there was one of the Gauguins was playing the ukulele on the tender, taking us into the motu.
Yeah.
So you get a lot of introduction to ukulele and Tahitian dance and song.
Yeah.
This is the area actually where I was saying we have early risers breakfast. The other thing it reminds me to tell you is that we also have nightly, more for lack of a better word, a disco. So there's music playing, those doors open up there and you can dance out under the stars. It's really a lot of fun because the islands themselves aren't really known for a lot of you know, disco late night entertainment. Mm-hmm. So there's other areas on board the ship that you can be quietly reading or contemplating. But in the evenings, if you're interested in staying up and partying a bit, this is a really fun area.
I usually know that area from the late night, not the early risers.
Yeah, I have to admit, I always say in the mornings they have croissant and coffees and pastries and a smoothie bar. I just know that because people tell me that. I've never actually seen it, but it's true.
I'm just going to hop over to the comments for 1 second, Vicky, just so we've had a few more that have come in. Liz was just commenting. What did I just do with Liz's comment? Oh, she tried to convince me to join their cruise the week prior, but failed. I know. I wish I had that much time on my hands. I wish I did, Liz. because Liz is doing the beautiful sailing that goes from Fiji to Tahiti, and then she gets off the ship and we get on the ship. So we crossing paths. We'll have to see if we can connect in between there. And
you'll see, Liz, you'll see there's tons of lectures because we do have the sailings that we have where we have more sea days. We definitely augment with additional lectures. So
Yeah, Liz, remind me and I can let you know who's the guest lecturers are on your sailing as well. So, yeah. And then Jeff, hello, Jeff. Jeff and Karen, I just talked to them this week. If Luke's there behind stage, Jeff and his wife Karen are already booked. They're going to be on board with us, and they are lovely, fun people. So looking forward to meeting them in person. There's their second time going down, but this, that should be really good. And Greg, thank you, Greg, for joining once again. I hope you enjoy the show. And one day, Greg, we are going to get you there as well. and Noelle. Can't wait for the croissants.
Oh, they are the best croissant. You know, the other thing we have now, too, since we were purchased by Panon, is the French butter. It's goodness, it's just out of this world. It's nice. Fabulous.
Yeah. Nice. Noelle leaves soon. We've already done her Bon Voyage call. She's all set. She's doing the sailing with Paul Gauguin. So she's super excited. So thanks for joining, Noelle. Okay, back to our presentation, though.
Slide on lectures. Because we're going to talk with Luke a bit, so we'll talk about he'll talk about what a lecture would do on board. But just know on all of our sailings, we're so much more than just sun and sand. There are lectures, lots of marine biologists, whale and dolphin experts, anthropologists, and then from time to time we bring on other interesting folks like Luke.
Yes, yeah, and a wide variety of interesting folks too. You all sorts of different lecturers.
Yeah. We should do one of these days one with just the variety of lectures that we have.
Totally.
Yeah, that would be a good one too. Yeah. Marina at the aft of the ship, so the paddleboarding and the kayaking is included. We always include the snorkel gear. I think the next slide is our PADI certified dive program. Mm-hmm. And just know we have dive masters right on board the vessel. So if you're a diver, this is great because you go right from the marina on a Zodiac or a speedboat out diving. You get to go port to port with the same dive masters, which is really nice. Scuba diving is considered a shore excursion, just know. So it starts at about $125 for the scuba diving program. But
And just to say, I mean, we're going to get more into the itinerary, but this itinerary that we're doing is famous for divers. I have another couple that are already booked on the sailing with this as well. And they chose it because they're divers. So it certainly is an itinerary that for divers, take a good look at this because we overnight in Whakarava, which is one of the most famous places for diving. And same with Rangiroa, where you can dive. Whakarava is famous for their sharks and Rangiroa famous for their dolphins, which, and lots of other stuff too. But those are two of the biggest claims to fame for those places. So yeah, amazing cruise for doing some diving.
And just really quickly wanted to show you the staterooms and suites, just to give you an idea of the ship was completely renovated. It's about 2 years ago now, with all of the public areas and the staterooms were redone. Owner suites start at about 600 square feet. And this is, you've added your prices here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good.
Just to show people the savings because we've got a group allotment on this sailing to join us. You know, if you were to call Paul Gauguin today to book this, it'd be $17,320 per person for the owner's suite. But if you call Sherry or myself to book it, you're going to save $2,200 per person. So $4,400. So it's not only is it great savings, but you get all of our knowledge and expertise. You know, we've sailed many times. We know the islands. We'll help you plan the shore excursions, your pre, your post, your flights, whatever you might need. We're there for you. Yeah. So,
well, you know, I'll just tell everyone, last time in the fall when I was traveling to Tahiti, I needed transfers and hotels and iPhone Carl.
So we got the owner's suite, and then we got the grand suite, next one down, right?
Grand suites. I love this category. There's only two of them on board the vessel, but there's this lovely balcony. And when you go outside of the balcony to the right there, half of the bow of the ship is your own private balcony. Mm-hmm. It's like having your own yacht when you're going in and out of port. Absolutely amazing. And every stateroom, regardless of the category, has beautiful bedding and bathrobes and linens, full bathtubs in there's only a couple that are showers and they're huge showers, but everything else is huge bathtubs as well.
Yeah. If you give me the grand suite on this sailing, I'll make sure I invite everybody for a cocktail party. On the big balcony.
On the big balcony. Okay.
We'll take pictures and film it for promo purposes for you.
But the prices, the savings that you have, it's because we lock in as soon as I know the schedules are coming out, you and I start talking about these, yeah, and we lock them in. So
for sure.
Now, this is the vast majority of the ship is, are these outside staterooms like this, almost 250 square feet. They've got the nice balconies and same thing I said, like the beautiful bathrooms and linens, mini bar sort of in your staterooms that's replenished daily. And then there's a category down. Did you price these ones are $1,280. Did you price the outside staterooms too?
Yeah. So the category B, I was just going to tell people, this truly is like, you know, unless you can afford the big suites. And there's the category A, like we aren't showing all the cabins, but category B I love because it's right on the pool deck. So I love the location. Like I always say, the cabin's a little larger, the balcony's a little larger, but the location is so key. And then you get a butler service. And I have so many clients say, I don't need a butler. I'm like, I know you may not need a butler.
Yeah.
But I'm telling you, they add to the experience so much. There's every time I opened the cabin door on my last sailing, Harry would be hollering down the hallway, "Hello, Mr. Carl." you know where he was, but he was around. And you know, the butlers are fantastic. So I love category B. So that's why I added that. But you didn't have that in your presentation. I added that slide in. So
that same deck is where the grand suites are at the end of that.
Yes.
At that same deck. So it is my favorite actually.
Too. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, and sorry, I'm just going to pop up this comment right now too, because Sarah was on that cruise with me. And so Sarah, that works with us as well, is watching right now. She's not backstage, but she's watching and she's saying Harry, because Sarah loves Harry. Sarah and her mom had a cabin. Harry the butler. Sarah and her mom had a cabin, and every morning, I think Harry would show up with coffee and I'm not sure what else for Sarah's mom, and Sarah would still be in bed sleeping, and Harry would tiptoe into the room and put the coffee out on the balcony so her mom could have the coffee out there on the balcony, and then Sarah would wake up afterwards and Harry would take care of them
it's the anticipating people's and knowing people's comfort levels too, right?
Yeah.
That it's so intuitive to them.
And just a couple other comments since we jumped over the comments. Hello, Maddie. Thanks for joining. Maddie's here every single week. But Maddie, you're late today. 5:23, you commented. Usually Maddie's like 20 minutes before the show making her hellos. And Wendy wanders the world. Wendy, it's good to see you. I haven't seen you on our shows there for a while. Wendy's question popped in during the dive.
Oh, refresher class. Oh, okay. Yes. Yeah, there's refreshers. You can get certified actually on board. And it is important. Yeah, speak with Carr and Sherry, and they can give you an idea too on the degree, the level of expertise. I'm not a diver, can you tell? But the level of expertise you need to be doing some of the dives. Because in the Tuamotus, you do need to have a certain level of...
And you have to be an advanced diver for the two.
Yeah. And even if I'm just so you know, there's some great snorkeling there as well. Yes. But I would say, like, my husband is not a very strong swimmer. And he was not so crazy about, like, there was some currents and that sort of thing. So even if you're just swimming, when you get out to the sea and the Tuamotus, there's some motion in the water.
Yeah, yeah. There's some amazing, amazing snorkeling. That's where you will find me for sure on some of these days, because I love it. So... but yeah, you can definitely do the refresher courses. It is super important to anybody that's looking to dive to remember, we will be giving you a guest information form. You have to tick off that you're interested in diving, and we'll talk to you about how to get on board the ship and go book your diving right away, especially on this cruise, because it will be super popular. And you do need to complete some dive forms in advance, including getting a medical. So you want to get all of that organized ahead of time. But just let us know that you're diving. Sherry and I, let us know that you're divers, and we'll make sure that you get all the right information for that, so you don't miss out.
I was mistaken. This is the category that most of the ship is like. That is category C and D, with which are 240 square feet.
Yeah.
So that too, you have $1,000 savings. And that again has a beautiful balcony.
Yeah. And that price that you're seeing is the category C, which is the higher one. The category D is already sold out, folks.
Okay.
So that means the space is moving on this cruise, and Luke and I want to have you on board with us. So reach out to us so we can get you booked for this great opportunity. And then I did pop in just to show people, if you're on more of a budget, there is a category E. There's also a category F. So the E is the window, right? And the F is a porthole cabin. Not that I recommend them, because you're in French Polynesia, you want a balcony. So thankfully,
you want to open the balcony and smell the fresh air and see, you can see how close you are into the islands. And
yeah. But if, you know, if it means not going at all versus doing this, then better to do that, right?
So, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And this, we just wanted to show that you do want a balcony in French Polynesia.
Yeah. Yeah. You can really, it makes such a difference. Especially when you got full room service, you know, it's so nice. And a fully stocked mini bar that they, you know, refill every day. And Paul Gauguin is the type of ship where you will meet other people. And you might want to say, hey, come back to our balcony and let's have a glass of wine together or something like that. So it's nice that you can do those things.
Mm-hmm. We do get a lot of people celebrating a milestone birthday or anniversary. If it's an anniversary or a honeymoon, we have a Polynesian blessing ceremony on board that's complimentary. So just let Carl or Sherry, sorry, know that it's your anniversary and we'll invite you to this blessing ceremony. Yeah. Beautiful. You know, this really is a highlight, and it's our private beach. No one else ever goes to Motu Mahana other than our guests. And it is just a fabulous day of sun and sand. And the water here is 28 degrees year round. It's crystal clear, bathwater warm. The one side you can walk out 15 minutes and you're up to your chest in bathwater warm water. The other side, there's drift snorkeling. We have barbecue. We have floating bar. Everyone's drinking out of coconuts. The Gauguins are there. They're showing people maybe how to tie a pareo or cultivate a pearl. It's just a really, really fun day.
Yeah. It's a favorite for everybody all the time.
Yeah. And you could, and you could go back and forth all day to the Motu. I had someone ask me, they were thinking it was like an excursion that there were a limited amount of people that go, but everyone on the ship can fit on Motu Mahana, as our private beach in Bora Bora. And here it's just sand and trees and a cooler with drinks.
Yeah.
We actually have a few lounge chairs now. We never used to even have lounge chairs. You just took a towel and laid in the sand. But this is iconic, this view with Mount Otamanu in the background.
It's gorgeous. It's one of my favorite beaches in Bora Bora. It's now our itinerary. We're going to have to go quickly.
Vicky. I know. We talk too much. We told ourselves we weren't going to do it.
I know. And I said, because I know Luke can talk too. So we ought to go quickly here so we give him some time.
Okay. We'll throw out a few ideas of why you want to do this itinerary. You do want to spend time with Papeete, right?
Yeah. I mean, I usually recommend people fly in a day or 2 days before the cruise. Get adjusted to the time zone. You know, you can go see the picture in the right is the market. You can go see the market. We've got a lot of great tours of the East Coast, the West Coast, the Inner Papineau Valley, or you can just chill out. There's beautiful resorts there. And it's where the bulk of the population lives. So there's lots you can see or do, or just relax and do nothing before you board the ship. But you definitely want to get in there at least a day before the cruise.
Mm-hmm. And here you have a sea day. You know, the sea days, this is Luke, you're going to be lecturing right from day one. So the sea day is really where we do have a bit more programming on board. There's everything. It's just a perfect day to enjoy the ship and enjoy everything that there is that the vessel has to offer. From the performances to shopping, the paddle boards, the kayaks as well.
Well, no paddle boards or kayaks on your
days. Oh, yes, because we're at sea. Yes.
You know, kayaking along to try to keep up to the ship, you get your exercise.
That's for those people trying to lose weight when they're on board.
Vicky, I told her she has to talk quicker.
You know what's funny? I got to take that picture off there because I've probably said that before too.
So Fakarava is our first stop. And like Vicky said, we get into Fakarava, I think at 2 p.m. And we overnight in Fakarava. And Fakarava is out in the Tuamotu Islands. It is so remote. It has got such small population. It's a completely different world. I mean, for those people that really want to experience the isolation, it's amazing. For divers that really want to have some incredible diving, like said advanced divers, you know, it's amazing. For snorkelers, it's amazing. You can rent bikes, you can do ATVs. You know, it's just a really, really unique destination. And we'll have the afternoon there and then the full next day in Bacaraba, right?
Mm-hmm. I did actually the e-bikes. You don't really need an e-bike in Bacaraba, but yes, they were all nice. But you needed more Raya, but it was actually fun too. It was a fun tour because you can pretty much do the whole island.
The whole island, yeah. And then we go to Rangiroa.
Yeah, beautiful diving again. You know, just pristine beaches.
Diving, snorkeling. There's the Paul Gauguin, no relation to Paul Gauguin cruises, but there is the Paul Gauguin pearl shop there that you can visit, pearl farm, I mean, that you can visit to learn how pearls are grown and cultivated. And you can even, depending on what the guys are doing at the time you're there, you know, you see them opening the oysters and, you know, shucking and getting the pearls out, and they teach you everything about it. So it's so that can be an interesting little visit to do when you're in Rangiroa, which I've been to Rangiroa many times, but I've never done it on the cruise. So I look forward to seeing it from the, you know, from the cruise perspective. And we've got a full day there too. I think we get in like at 7 or 8 in the morning and stay until right until the end of the day. So it's nice. And Huahine?
Archaeological sites, the Maori temples. There is beautiful sand, like pure white sand beaches, some of the most amazing beaches. And just, it's like going back 200 years.
Exactly what I was going to say. It's a step back in time. You know, it's kind of what Moorea was before Moorea got more populated. It's really more quiet, more laid back. I mean, when it comes to hotels and resorts, there's only two hotels there now, and they are both tiny little lodges, right? And otherwise it's just little guest houses, so you can't even have that many visitors there. So the locals still really lead an authentic way of life on Huahine, and there is those great, you know, archaeological things that you can see in the old stone fishing traps and things like
that. I was gonna say stone fishing traps are really kind of cool.
Yeah, it's really interesting. Lazy man fishing, so
yeah. Bora Bora, you know, probably one of the most romantic places in the world. I think that most people in their mind, when they're picturing going to French Polynesia, they're thinking about Bora Bora.
Yeah. Truly the most beautiful place in the world, in my opinion. You know, it's just nothing matches the beauty of Bora Bora. And it's all about, you got to get out on the water in Bora Bora. I know we got a picture of a Jeep safari there, but you don't do a Jeep safari unless you've been out on the lagoon first. You know, and if you're beach lovers, go to the private beach, is that's
And the other thing I love about Bora Bora is the snorkeling. Well, everywhere in French Polynesia, really. So if I'm not a diver, but I'm a snorkeler, you really don't need to be a diver to see sharks and stingrays and every kind of coral and fish you can possibly imagine. And then we're just showing that you have the opportunity to go back and forth to our private beach while you're overnighting there. This is our first return we have to Raiatea in 11 years, actually, it's been since we've been. And it has great cultural significance to the Polynesians.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's got the UNESCO, the picture, middle picture. That's Tapua Tapuatea, which is the UNESCO World Heritage Site, because it's an ancient Polynesian marae, but it has cultural significance to all Polynesians, not just French Polynesians. So it's, really big. If anybody's really into the history and the culture, we can get a tour going there for you.
That tiari flower, too, the picture that was there, they're only found on Raiatea.
Yeah.
It's the emblematic flower of Tahiti, but that type you can only get in Raiatea. You can see. Yeah.
And then we've got Anna.
Beach day.
And then we're over.
I love Moorea, too. I love where the ship comes in and you get so close and there's, eight beautiful mountain peaks and very lush. Comes down to beautiful white sand beaches.
Yeah. Moorea is such a great island. We get a lot of clients that go, and think Bora Bora is going to be their favorite, but then come back and say Moorea is their favorite. You know, because Moorea, I always say, is beautiful by land and by lagoon, and you want to, Moorea definitely needs to do a little bit of land excursions in Moorea, in my opinion, because it is different. You'll do a lot of lagoon everywhere else, but in Moorea, so we can help you plan what to.
It's good fun for e-bikes too. You can do the e-bike up to the Belvedere. That's a good one.
Yeah, we love that. I just did that. Eric and I just did that when we were there last time. I loved it. Loved it. And then we're back to Papeete. So it's, yeah, it's a really, really nice itinerary. And then we always recommend pre and post, right? Which is the huge advantage of working with Sherry and myself is that we don't just, a lot of, you know, realistically, it's not hard to book a cruise. But when you start adding in the different elements of a pre and a post and your excursions and tours and what to do and to make sure you don't do a tour in Huahine and do a tour in Moorea and find out they're almost the exact same, you know, and you feel like you wasted a day, right? That's where we're here to help, is to guide you through all of that process. So, so yeah, whether you're going to do the cruise only or whether you're going to do like Jeff and Karen that are on the call and they're talking about spending like an extra, what are we at, 9 nights after the cruise. So, you know, it's, you know, whatever you have time for, budgets for, we can work with you to make it work.
Not quite Ramamaru yet, because you can bring on Luke, aren't you?
Exactly. So this is the Marudu from the Vicky side of the presentation. But then we're going to pop into Luke. So so let me bring Luke on stage here. Sorry, get my cursor in the right place. And hello, Luke.
Hello. I love seeing all those gorgeous pictures. I'm so excited about the trip.
Because you have cruised a lot, right?
I have, yes. Yes, yeah, but I've never been to Tahiti.
Never been to Tahiti. Yeah.
It's more beautiful than any picture you've ever seen. And I just know you're going to come back and you're going to agree with me.
You had me at, Vicky, you had me at the croissants and the French butter.
which is actually going back to how this all started. That's how Luke and I actually met in France.
In the French Riviera last summer. Exactly.
Yeah. It was last summer. Eh? Yeah. Seems yes. A long time ago, but yeah, it was just last summer. So yeah, last summer in the French Riviera, a mutual friend had rented a villa, and I didn't know Luke and or his partner or him and my partner, and we had what was there, 1, 2, 3, was there 8 of us?
Yes,
8 of us, mm-hmm. 8 of us in a villa for a week in the French Riviera, and that's how we met. And then I got talking. He said, "Hey, Luke, you should come on board a cruise with me and do some of your talks and some of your," and he's like, "Why not? Right?"
We're thrilled to be asked.
So tell us a bit more about yourself, Luke, because you've got a huge history, primarily like theater, you know, theater and entertainment based, right?
Yes, indeed. Very much a showbiz kind of kid. I have, as you mentioned earlier, I have worked as an actor, a director, a producer, a playwright, an author writing about the theater. And I am the son of the actress Eileen Heckart, who won this guy for the film Butterflies Are Free. Couldn't resist so having cool. A prop here.
That's so cool. I've never held, obviously. Most people really. Never have or will.
It's quite a little prop.
Yeah, it's quite a little prop to have on the desk, absolutely. But in my programs, I tell a lot of the stories from my book, Just Outside the Spotlight, about me growing up in this crazy, almost anti-MAME kind of showbiz world where Ethel Merman taught me how to make a martini at age 10. Paul Newman gave me acting lessons in my parents' living room, meeting people like Marlena Dietrich and Joanne Woodward and Mary Tyler Moore, and just kind of the who's who of Broadway and Hollywood, mm-hmm. Just not only from the people I've worked with, but the people who my mother worked with over the years. Yeah. Very fun stories about fielding calls from reporters at age 13, the night my mother won the Academy Award. And again, I put this all into a book, Just Outside the Spotlight, and which
Mary Tyler Moore actually wrote the foreword. I have your book here. She actually wrote the
foreword, right? Exactly. Yeah. Yes, Mary was a dear friend.
Yeah, she wrote the foreword to the book, which is very touching when you read it.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Mary was a dear family friend. And my mother, one of the things she was the most known for in television was she played Mary's, for any of you who remember the old Mary Tyler Moore show, she played Mary's Aunt Flo and was a tough, hard-bitten newspaper woman who had an affair with Lou Grant. And very, very funny episodes that my mom did on that. And so she and Mary remained great friends. And Mary was very dear to me. And I was so touched that she chose to write the foreword for the book. And so, goodness, what else can I tell you? You want to ask me questions?
Yeah, let me go. I put some slides in. Let me just see what we have. So we talked about your books. So you've got the books. If anybody wants to, this is what the book looks like. You can buy it on Amazon, right? If you are going to join us on the cruise and you want to learn a little bit more about Luke and his history and his stories, you can pick up a copy of the book, bring it with you. I'm sure he'll be happy to sign it for you on board the cruise.
Absolutely.
As well. And now this is something else that Vicky and I actually talked about. Do you think we could go see the play? this was your latest yes. production, right?
Yes.
Tell us a bit about this and how it went, because it just closed.
Thank you. It did indeed. My mother played Marilyn Monroe's best friend in the film A Bus Stop. And the year before Marilyn shot Bus Stop, she went to the Actors Studio in New York and studied with Lee Strasberg and had become the poster child for method acting, where one has to feel everything organically. And since my mother was playing Marilyn's best friend, Marilyn was determined to make my mother her best friend. And at first, Mom, who was a very, you know, very, very kind of salty lady and very much a straight shooter, was sort of like, well, who's this starlet who's glomming onto me and making me feel very uncomfortable? But the two of them wound up really bonding. And to the day my mother died, she could never talk about Marilyn Monroe without bursting into tears. And I knew there was something really powerful there. So I started doing some more research. Of course, I knew a lot of my mother's stories about Marilyn. And I created a play called Marilyn, Mom and Me that just had its world premiere at the Equity Theater near where I live in Long Beach, California. Theater called International City Theater. We broke box office records, played to sold out houses, standing ovations at every performance. Nice. And there is a lot of interest in the play for Broadway and for other regional theaters around the country. So I couldn't be more thrilled about it and just really delighted that it's gotten that kind of response. I've got the script out right now to some pretty major A-level talent to see if any of them would consider, any of these major actresses would consider doing a limited run on Broadway. You can see there the actress I have playing Marilyn is a woman named Alicia Soper, who is Ryan Murphy's go-to person for Marilyn. And she's extraordinary.
Yeah, it looks like you got Marilyn on stage there, right?
Totally. Totally. Yeah. And she sounds like her. I mean, the mannerisms and everything, it's just incredible. And so, I just couldn't be more thrilled about this play. And I'm sure by the time I'm on board the ship, I'll have, you know, my fantasy is that I'll be coming from the Broadway run onto the Paul Gauguin. That's what I'm manifesting here.
Us too, yeah.
Yeah, well, maybe I'll come with you, because if it is Broadway, I'm coming down to see it. That sounds
good to me.
That's quick and easy. And I've been reading all sorts of the reviews, and it just really seems to be, you know, fantastic. So
thank you. Yeah,
it's congrats just on that. I think this is the thing for people that do join us on the cruise. So you are going to do, I think it's my next slide. So you are going to do a couple different topics, which we talked about doing the Hollywood legends and backstage on Broadway, right?
Exactly. Yes. Yes, exactly. And I have amazing stories about the Academy Awards, as it says there, Betty Davis, Paul Newman, the night I met Marlene Dietrich at age 15. And then, of course, since most of the time when I was a kid, my mother was working on Broadway, great stories about Ethel Merman, Carol Channing, Arthur Miller, Bob Fosse, so many others. I could write a book, and I have.
You've written more than one book, I believe, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
So these are the two topics that Luke is going to lecture about. We'll figure out what days and, of course, let everybody know. But the other thing is that when you are joining, especially because not only is Luke a guest lecturer, but he's one that I found to join us. And Vicky has, you know, helped arrange all of this. But we get opportunities to network with Luke, too. I mean, on board the ship, it's a small ship. He's going to be on board with my partner, his partner. I'm going to be on board with my partner. But we're going to do two cocktails, cocktail parties. So one will be exclusive for somebody that books with us. So if you book through Tahiti by Carl, then we'll have an exclusive cocktail party with Luke, which I think would be really interesting too, to hear more about, you know, the whole playwright side and how you do it and the whole thought process of, you know, and how long things take. And, you know, I think, I don't know, it's the businessman in me. I think all the business, you know, the whole business side of that, but there's opportunities. We'll do one cocktail party for, you know, for just our guests. And there'll be another one that'll be open to the whole ship. He's going to do two lectures on board, but then you always get the opportunities to network, you know, around the ship or, you know,
I have a lot more stories than we'll cover we'll fill two cruises. So rather. So a lot more than that. There's a lot more where that came from. So I'm happy to chat with people and, you know, maybe celebrities that you didn't get to ask about in the lectures and that sort of thing. So yes, I look forward to sharing my stories with you all.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I have to say on the back of the book, I love that picture of you and your mom that you've got.
Yeah, that was, I gave that to her for Christmas and said, this is the way I always want to remember us.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yeah, that's great. So, yeah. So once we sell
that cigarette in her hand.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what you said. She was a big chain smoker, right?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, back in the day, that's the way they live.
One off, back in the day. Absolutely.
Yeah. 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 Does anybody have anything?
I'm thinking the opportunity just to, you know, be hanging out around the pool and, sail away time and visiting with Luke and just being able to, you know, ask questions. And there's so much of that on a small ship like that, that you really do get to meet people close up, which is.
And on excursions too, you know, people book an excursion, you're on a 4x4 tour and you're sitting in the back of a 4x4 and you never know who's, you know, who else is there, and you get to network and talk with them. And I mean, Paul Gauguin has such an easy ship for meeting people. And Luke, as you can tell, is very extroverted. He's very talkative. That's not an issue. He's not a shy guy.
Not at all. From the time I was a little boy, I mean, I would sit at my mother's feet at these cocktail parties where there would be Teresa Wright and the playwright Robert Anderson, and who were both dear family friends. Oh, goodness. Of course, Mary Tyler Moore, as you mentioned. So many people. And I would just sit there like a sponge from the time I was a little kid and just listen to all these stories and then soak them in. Yeah. And I knew my mother would never write a book. And so I was sort of the keeper of the flame. And so the only thing I love more than knowing these short stories is being able to share them with people.
Mm. Yeah, it's great. It's great because you have so many of them. I heard so many in France. And it's, yeah. No, really interesting, especially for people that are Hollywood, you know, and like that golden age of Hollywood and everything, they can really.
Indeed, yes.
Yeah. If anybody watching has any questions or comments here, please feel free to drop them in. I can't remember if we have, no, we didn't really have any other slides. So we are definitely open to questions. Vicky, do you have anything else that you wanted to ask or comment? Actually, I'm going to bring Sherry back on too. Still there, yeah. Sherry?
Well, you know, I think just this is a fabulous itinerary. You know, of course, we have everything from 7 to 20-day itineraries. But this one, I think, in particular, just because you do get to see so many destinations, return to Raiatea, overnight in Fakarava. I think it's, if all you've wanted to do is go to French Polynesia, I think that's fabulous. But then also the fact that Carl and Luke will be on board, I think that just makes it so much more fun.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to it. And we've got some clients that have already booked are great clients. They're lots of fun. So I'm really looking forward to, really looking forward to having 10 days on board with everybody and get to know them and feel, because, you know, when you travel, it can be crazy intense how well you get to know people in such a short period of time. I see my whole face is hidden on this, but yeah, how well you get to know people in such a short period of time when you're traveling like that. So
I was gonna say, you're gonna have to kick one of us off so we can see you.
just remove the banner. But if anybody is interested in joining us on this cruise, of course we've got our toll-free number here. We got Sherry here. Sherry's very happy to help organize and book it. Sherry is actually, if you want to cruise with Sherry, Sherry and Sarah will be cruising in November. What is it? November what, Sherry?
8th of 2025.
November 8th, 2025 there. And their cruise is selling it even faster. Yeah. It's a 7-nighter, but it's really, space is really disappearing there. But we've got the 10-nighter.
I want to go on yours now too.
Yeah, but you can. Me too.
I know, it sounds great.
Yeah, it should be. It should be good fun. I'm looking forward to it. A couple more comments that have come in. Oh, Noelle, let's talk. Let's talk tomorrow. Yeah, you need to bring your dive book, but you do need, there's medical for, I don't know if I realized you were going to dive, but Noelle, let's touch base tomorrow and I'll get you all the forms for diving. Mary Ellen, thank you for joining. If you missed the beginning of the show, you can go back. The recording will be on YouTube, so you can watch it there. And Liz, will be a fascinating cruise. Well, Liz, maybe you need to do back-to-backs. You know, Liz, you can just stay on board for another 10 days. You and Sylvain, you're retired, and come join us.
There's an additional discount for doing back-to-backs. Think of the money you'll save.
Additional discount back-to-backs, additional discount past passengers, additional discount Canadian residents. We'll get you the best price. Come join us. But if anybody's interested in booking in, of course, give us a call, the toll-free number there. This is the link to our website that we have the details of the cruise on board there and Luke's bio online there, so you can do that. And then the contact us page, of course, on the website. We're reachable anyway, but email our planning forms or whatever it is. But like I say, Category D, we didn't check, Vicky, the percentage of the ship.
You know what? I'm going to do that right now. I actually started doing it, and then it was...
I know the Category D, I think, is the only cabin category that's sold out, but it's a busy booking time right now. This is the time when a lot of people are doing their plannings and their bookings.
So. Yeah, currently 50% occupancy. So when you think this is more than a year out, one of the owner's suites is already gone.
Yeah.
So there's
we have your cabin all held, don't worry.
So 50% occupancy, if you're thinking this far in advance, need to get booking it fairly quickly. Our deposits are 25%. The balance is due 90 days before you go. So the vast majority of it is paid closer in. But we had sailings, even some of our sailings for this year sold out 18 months in advance. So it is very busy.
Yeah. And for anybody that's looking at doing pre and post, when you work with Sherry and I on that, there is a bit of an advantage to booking early right now too, because our 2024 contracted rates, most of our suppliers will honor those for 2025 if people are booking early, and every year the prices go up. So if we get you booked before our new contracts come in place, you know, you're going to get a better deal. So we can work on, that for anybody who's, looking at doing some pre and post to the cruise as well. So great. Good. Okay. Well, I don't think there's any other comments here. So I want to thank everybody for joining. Luke, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy day. And
my great pleasure. So excited about the cruise.
Yes. I look forward to, we'll be in touch more and we'll talk about what you and Don would like to do for pre and post as well. And, flights will be available about 11 months prior, so we can't do those yet. But so Vicky, sorry, Mike's just asking, was that 50% or 15%?
50.
50. 50.
Yeah.
So 50%. So it's much fuller than, it's much, much more full than I thought. So that's.
But yeah, that's, last time we talked, it was maybe even about 3-4 weeks ago. And I think it was maybe almost 40. So
I was going to say 36 last time.
Yeah.
I mean, 330 cabins can disappear fast, right?
Well, that's the thing, right?
The whole world can buy into it. So yeah. So good. Okay. So thank you so much, Luke. I appreciate you joining. Sherry, I know you didn't get to talk much today, but
that's okay.
We got your face out here for people that are looking at book. I sometimes can be super, super busy. You know, don't be shy to reach out to Sherry as well. And Vicky, as always, thank you so much. You're always
my pleasure.
Always great joining on here. We always have fun. Maddie, thank you for joining. And yes, have a great weekend too. I know every time I finish my show, I know it's Thursday night and it's like one more day and then it's the weekend. So, okay, as they say in Tahiti, maruru, everybody. Take care and we will see you all next week.
Maruru.
Bye-bye.